Good morning. It's Sunday morning. I hope you're ready to have a great kids' church this morning. Now, before we begin, we're going to say our pledges. So I want you to stand with me, and we're going to pledge to the American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And to the Christian flag, I pledge allegiance to the Christian flag and to the Savior for whose kingdom it stands, one Savior, crucified, risen, and coming again with life and liberty to all who believe. All right. You know what we've been talking about for the last little bit? Just about getting close to God and what God wants to do for us. Now, I want to ask you something. Do you have a best friend? Does anybody have a best friend or somebody who's just a really good friend? If you have a good friend, I want you to raise your hand. Do you have a good friend? Okay. So, on the count of three, I'm going to count to three, and then I want you to say who your good friend is. Ready? Okay. Get ready. Got it in your mind? All right, here we go. One, two, three. Okay. I almost heard everybody say who their friend was. Now, when you have a friend, you talk to each other, right? Now, how would you feel if that person that you just mentioned, your friend, your really, really good friend, wouldn't talk to you anymore? I mean, you would feel sad. You would think, what's the matter? Why aren't they talking to me? Well, you know what? Friends talking to each other, our relationship, and the Lord wants a relationship with you. He wants you to talk to Him, and that's what we're going to be talking about tonight. And we have a PowerPoint, and the Lord really misses it when you don't talk to Him, and this PowerPoint is going to help you remember that, okay? Are you ready? Here it goes. I talk to God in prayer because I have a relationship with Him, okay? All right, let's try it again. I talk to God in prayer because I have a relationship with Him. You know what? The Lord wants you to talk to Him, and that's what we're going to be talking about tonight. Now, get ready, buckle your seatbelts, or maybe I should say unbuckle your seatbelts, and let's go with Sister Amy and the band.
So ready for, good morning. I'm so ready for Kids Church. Okay. So let's start off by saying we've got a new song. We have got a new song. And it is, so Olivia's making us do it. There she is on that side. She's making us do this new song. And you know, it takes her just like a blink of an eye and she's got a new song. It takes me a blink of an eye plus 3 years to know a song. You know that. And Felicity, I think your dad did this one time in kids' church with like scripture memory verse or worship, and we listened to it, but now we're doing the motions. Okay, so it's called Our God is So Big, So Strong, and So Mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. So, Olivia, please come up right. There you are. There you are. Here we go. Olivia. These are the, she's going to show us the motions. Michaela knows it too, but it, you know, I have to, since she's my daughter, I have to say, Olivia, I'm good about telling her what to do. So here we go. Olivia, let's show them the motions. You're going to need to probably get a big area because you're going to be jumping, okay? Okay, here we go. Our God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. Oh, okay, we're going to do it again a couple more times. Our God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. One more time. Here we go. Our God is so big, so strong, and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. Okay, so here's the deal. That's the chorus, and there's a couple verses, and the verses got a lot of words, and you'll probably see, I might just step back because there's a lot of motions, But these girls got it, and just get ready. So I wish I had my front row kids here, because I just love seeing you guys. I love all you guys just jumping around. Man, Camden and Em and Zoe, I probably need you guys up here with me, and Carson and Samuel, but man, I miss you guys. I miss all of you guys. Oh, but we're going to do this. We're going to try it. Everybody say, hit it, Brother Phil.
Hit Brother Phil.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big and so strong and so mighty. There's nothing my God cannot do. In the beginning, God made everything. God simply spoke and the world came to be. He sent a flood and made everything new. He parted the sea and let his people walk through. He helped a boy bring a giant right down. Joshua marched, the walls fell to the ground. These acts of power are worthy of praise. But if you want to question my God and his ways, I'll look you in the eye and say, my God. So big and so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
He can't do.
My God is so big and so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Though we are sinners, he still gave us worth. God sent his son to live here on the earth. He healed the sick, he made blind men see. He let the lame walk and he said,
because can you see I'm a little red right now? That was fun. Okay, what is our next song? I am like blank right now. Oh, how could I forget me without, oh, I'm so glad Jesus was with me all the time. What would I do without him? So me without you. Remember this one, boys and girls, you're going to need room for this one because we're going to go boing, boing. Okay, remember all that? Uh-huh. So here we go. Me without you.
Raindrops rolling off my brim. Street lights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms, right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you? I'd be packing my bag when I need to stay. I'd be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'd be building my kingdom just to watch it fade away. It's true, that's me without you.
Speaking of Jesus, our next song, Cooper, I know it wasn't too long ago that you requested this song. Boy, time flies when you're having fun. Mm-mm. It has not been fun without you guys. We miss you so much. But Cooper, I know you love this song. It's called This Is Amazing Grace. Jesus, in your amazing grace. Oh, I love you tonight, Jesus. And we're going to sing about this amazing grace. And here we go. Amazing grace.
Sin and darkness, whose love is mighty and so. done for me.
With that song. That's okay. And if you ever want to hear those songs, remember they're on YouTube. And that one was by, and there's actually different people that sing that one, but that one was by Phil Wickman, and he does a great job. And that's the one we use in Kids Church, Amazing Grace. Oh, I love his Amazing Grace. So boys and girls, thank you so much for doing the emotions with me. Thank you for singing with the Thank you for singing with us, and oh, I just can't wait to see you again. So now it is time for Scripture Memory Verse, and here, take it away, Sister Olivia.
What amazing grace that God gives, that God has done so much for us. And when Jesus came down on this earth, he was a perfect example of how to pray. You might be wanting to grow closer in your relationship to God, but you wonder, how do I even do that? How do I pray? And Jesus prayed everywhere, that he was a perfect example, and that he prayed not only with his disciples or around people, but he had a prayer life when he was just alone. And so one day the disciples decided to ask him, Jesus, how do you pray? And our verse today, it comes from Matthew 6 verse 9, and it is his answer to the disciples saying how he prays. And he said, Our Father in heaven, we pray that your name will always be kept holy. And so some of you, sorry guys. So let's go over that one more time. Our Father in heaven. Okay, our Father in heaven, we pray that your name will always be kept holy. And so some of us might have a wrong view of the Father because we might have seen the example of our earthly fathers. And I know I've been blessed to have such a good father. Some of you know that Brother Kurt's my dad, but he's been such a great example. But some of us have fathers who may not meet our needs. They might even abandon us or they might abuse us. But we know that our Heavenly Father is not like that. He does not compare to any bad earthly father, that he is always loving, that he'll meet every need, that he'll care for you, that he will never leave you or forsake you, that he'll always be there with you. So you need to find in his word that God is always there and his name should always be kept holy. So let's say it one more time in Matthew 6 verse 9, Our Father in heaven, we pray that your name will always be kept holy. So my challenge for you this week is to keep that name holy and to pray and realize that a relationship with God is all that matters.
All right. It's good to see you guys again this morning. You know, it's been a week since Mother's Day, and today we're going to talk about someone who in the Bible has had a great desire to be a mother. A great desire. Her name was Hannah. Now, if you're following along with me, you can open your Bibles, and you can find out in 1 Samuel chapter, chapter 1, verses 1 through 20. So if you want to kind of read your Bibles, maybe after the lesson, or maybe if you want to read your Bible later on, you can find out how this, the what I'm getting ready to tell you about. But there was a lady, like I told you, her name was Hannah, and she had a great, great desire to have a child. In fact, she tried for years. She wanted to have a son so badly. In fact, she got to the point where finally her husband said, you know what? Don't I mean more to you than 10 sons? Why are you so desperate to have a son? But this did not comfort her. Year after year, she sought God. She knew God. It wasn't someone who didn't know God. She talked to God. She asked him, said, please, just give me a son. Finally, one year came that she was coming to the tabernacle in Shiloh, and she came and she knelt down to pray, and she was so desperate for a son. She cried out to God, and she says, and you know what? She was so desperate, the Bible tells us that she didn't even know what to say. It said that her lips were not even moving. Her lips were moving, but no words were coming out. There were no words. So she was sitting there. And I can imagine what you guys, if you were in church and you looked and you're like, what is going on? You know, there's somebody sitting there praying. Their lips are moving, but there's no words coming out. What's wrong with her? In fact, the priest, Eli, came up to her and said, hey, what are you doing? Can you not, what, are you drunk? He thought she had been drinking. And he's like, are you drunk? What are you coming to the temple drunk? And here was her response.
I'm not drunk. I'm just crying out to my God.
You know what? She wasn't drunk at all. In fact, Eli realized how desperate that she really was. Eli said, you know what? May you be comforted. Your God's going to hear what you have to say, and he's going to answer your prayer. And as she left, you know what? A few months later, she did have a son. Does anybody know what his name was? Somebody from our kids' church. Sister Amy mentioned him earlier. She had a little boy named Samuel. I know we have a Samuel in kids' church, but this little boy was named Samuel, which means heard by God. You know what? She had made that promise to God. She said, you can give me a son, if you just do this one thing for me, I will give him back to you all the days of his life. And she did what God had honored her prayer, and she honored God by giving him back to God. So tonight, you know, your Heavenly Father does hear you. When you cry out to him and you ask him for something, he doesn't, you know, sometimes Hannah felt like that God must not be listening to me. You know, I've gone years and God hasn't heard my prayer, but God did hear her prayer and he gave her the desires of her heart. So if there's something in your life that you're praying for, keep praying. God does hear you and he cares about your needs.
What a great lesson, Brother Kurt. And that's so true. God will answer your prayers, and sometimes they take time, but God will show his great mercy and answer those. And in the song that we're singing today is called Our God, and it says, Our God is greater, our God is stronger, God, you're higher than any other. And that is so true. Our God can do anything. It could be the smallest need or the biggest need. You can, I have a headache and I need it to go away. Or God, I have cancer. Lord, please take that away from my body. He can do either one because he is great. And please worship with me as we sing.
Into the darkness you shine, out of
Thank you, Jesus, for your love and your goodness and your greatness, Lord, and your mercifulness, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, Lord. Please help these kids right now, Lord. Let them know that they can do great things through you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. In Jesus' name.
Hello, all. It's good to be with you again. I am going to be doing the object lesson right now, and I started off this object lesson. They wanted me to get two people together who are kind of strangers with each other and have a conversation, try to have them have a conversation for 3 minutes. The problem was, since I'm in quarantine, kind of, I don't have a whole lot of people that I can have come and do this experiment. So I thought I'd talk to you a little bit about how, when you first meet someone and you don't know them very well, that sometimes it's kind of difficult to have a conversation with them for a very long time. And the experiment that I was going to do is to have two people who are kind of strangers talk for 3 solid minutes and see how they would do having a conversation and how that conversation would go. And I got to thinking about the first time that I met Brother Andy, who is now my son-in-law. And right at first, when you first meet someone, it's difficult to have long conversations. They wanted us to do a 3-minute conversation, and I got to thinking, how would I have had a conversation with Brother Andy right at first? And you know, when you first meet somebody, you say, oh, hello, well, it's nice to meet you. And then you talk about, you know, so where were you born? Are you going to school somewhere? What are you doing when you go to school? You know, what are you going to be in your life? And then the conversation kind of gets quiet. because then you're running out of things that you're talking about and you don't know what else to say. And so right at first, it's awkward because you don't know the person very well. Well, I've gotten to know Brother Andy now for about 6 years, and we have conversations with each other all the time. And we've done things together with the family, and we have dinners together. We've gone on vacation together. So for me to have a 3-minute conversation with Brother Andy is very, very easy. Now we talk about Felicity, things that are going on in the children's lives. Sometimes we talk about things that he's doing with the house and improvements that he's making and all the different things that he does during his day and all the different things that I do during my day. And so conversation with us is now easy and not difficult. And that's because we know each other. Now I'm going to kind of connect that with God. You know, when we first start having conversations with God, which is prayer, sometimes it's difficult to have a lot of things to say and a lot of things to talk about with the Lord because, quite frankly, you don't really know him very well. But after a while, when you spend time with him, you get to know him and it's easier to talk with him. Now, before, it wasn't that you didn't like God or that you didn't want to spend time with him. You just didn't really know what to say or how to converse with him. But the more time that you spend with someone, the more time that you do things with them in your life, then they become a part of who you are. And it gets easier and easier to have a conversation because you know about them and they know about you. Of course, God always knows everything about us because he created us, but I don't always know him if I don't allow him into my life through prayer. And so praying is just talking with God and spending time with him and talking about the things that matter in your life and listening to his voice when you read his word. You know, reading the Bible is part of my prayer time. And sometimes when I have prayer time, I'll turn on a song that's worshipful and I'll worship the Lord during my prayer time and think about all the wonderful things that he does and think about how much I love him and how grateful I am to him. And time with the Lord has become easier and easier because I just spend more time with him. I've gotten to know him. And so our PowerPoint today was, I can talk with God because he is my heavenly Father. And it's easy to talk with somebody when you love him, when you know him, and when spending time with him is important to you. And so listen now in the rest of these lessons as we talk and discuss more about how we can have conversation and prayer and talks with our heavenly Father.
Thank you, Sister Tracy. We're on the last part of our lesson today, and I have brought some wonderful helpers with me, and we're talking about how we can talk to our Heavenly Father. And so I have a box here, and inside it are some favorite things. And so they're going to pull out their object, and they're going to describe to them why they love it. So, Sister Michaela, since you have a microphone, you go first. Let's see what she's going to grab.
Alrighty. I have a book. Yes, this is one of my favorite things. It didn't used to be, but now it is. I love reading. I could spend hours reading not any type of book, but a good book that I like. But I like reading because it kind of takes me to a different place, a different perspective, and I don't know, I just enjoy it very much.
Well, thank you, Sister Michaela, and I can attest for you that she does love to read, and even, like, late at night, I'm like, when she should be sleeping, she's reading and reading and reading. So I can tell you, she loves to read. So, Sister Olivia, could you pick out an object and tell me why you love it, and what it is, and why you love it?
Okay, so one of my favorite objects is my phone because it makes my life a whole lot easier. Now, with a click of a button, I can talk to my friends, I can take a picture or watch a video, or I can even read on my phone that has a lot, it's multi-purpose. And so I really enjoy my phone, and I don't know now that we've had technology for a while, I don't know how I'd do life without my phone. That's hard to admit, but I'm sure most of you like your devices.
That's true. And I can say that I've seen Olivia with her phone in her hand a lot. So, and I brought an object too. So I brought one of my favorite things, Oreos. Double stuffed Oreos. Now, this has a lot, okay, I could talk a lot about double stuffed Oreos. It all began with my grandpa. And we would go over to his house, and he always had double stuffed Oreos. And he'd give us milk if we wanted milk, but then he'd also give us Coke to drink. But double stuffed Oreos, this is on my Walmart pickup order every week. It's a staple in our household. We have to have double stuffed Oreos, but we do limit ourselves to one package a week when we do. So we have to balance it, but it's balance. Goodness. It's a combination. Let me just tell you a little bit more about these double stuffed Oreos. I love them so much because they give you the crunchy cookie on the outside. And there's so many different ways that you can eat an Oreo. And I like to take off the top, and then I like to eat the bottom. That's one way if there's no milk present. But if there's milk present, I like to dunk them. So anyway, Oreos are close to my heart, and I love them. So anyway, you know, when people talk about things that they love, it's pretty easy to do. Look how much they could talk about it. I mean, I probably could go on more about these Oreos. I mean, I really could. I could sit down. We could talk about the different techniques of dunking them and how long you dunk them. But we could. It's so easy to do. And thank you, Olivia, and thank you, Michaela, for sharing your loves with us and explaining that. So you guys can have a seat. And we're going to finish up our lesson. And we're talking about talking to our Heavenly Father and building a relationship with him. And so, you know, Jesus teaches us that when we talk to him, and he showed us when he prayed that we should tell him how much we love him. You know, it's so easy to do. Look how easy it was to talk about those Oreos and how much I love Jesus more than I love double stuffed Oreos. We should explain that. We should let Jesus know how much we love him. That should be the most of what we do when we talk to him, is to tell him how much we love him and why we love him. That's the most important part of our prayer time, to let him know that we are created for worship, that he is worthy, he's the King of glory, that he died for us, that he loves us, that he shed his blood to save us so that we can be redeemed and so that we can see them in heaven. And that's what God wants to hear. Not just a list of demands, even though he knows and he wants you to send his requests to him, but he wants to know how much you love him. And so part of your prayer time is to talk to him and to praise him. And reading your Bible, of course, reading his word, and that's him speaking to you. But that praise and that worship, like Sister Michaela was playing that song, that let him know that he is greater, that he's greater than anything that we ever have come across. No matter what you're facing today, no matter what troubles may come, that God is above that. He can do all things, that he can make a way, and he is the way. He is the truth and the life, and we don't have to worry. And so when we take that time to talk to him, but sing songs of praise to him in the morning, at night, throughout your day, listen to those songs and lift him up. That's what God wants us to do. And I think that's probably the most important thing that we should do in our closing tonight, is that we just should praise him. We should stand on our feet, let him know how much he's loved, and maybe we could play that song again that Sister Michaela was saying. You know what? Let him know that he is great. He is worthy. Worthy is the Lamb, and that his grace is amazing. And we should just raise up our song, raise up our hearts to him, and let him know how much we love him. So maybe we could sing that song, part of that song in closing today, and let's just praise him. Let's just love on him and just let him know that he's number one in our life, that no matter what, that we're going to lean on him, that we're going to trust him, and we're going to seek him and search him in all things, that we're going to just love on him and let him know he can do all things.
Open the eyes of the
No one's like Jesus Christ. Praise you, Jesus.
Into the darkness you shine.
No matter what darkness you face, He'll light the way. There's no one like you, Jesus.
None like you.
Just feel like worshiping and standing and praising our God.
Our God is great.
harder. I got it stronger. God, you
look excited.
You're than any other. Our God is healer. Awesome in power.
Our God. Those words, let's speak them again. He's our what? He's our healer. He can do all things. That's great. He's awesome in power. I'm just so thankful for him today. And you know what? We'll just kind of close again. We just thank you, Jesus. We just want to thank you, Lord, for who you are, that you are worthy, that you died for us, God, and we just lift you up and just say that we love you. We love you so much, and Lord, we need you. We trust you, and God, we need you to guide our path and light the way. Lord, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus. And you know what? Have that light of Jesus in your heart this week. Let that praise, don't stop it. Just keep singing. Lift him up. And you know what? Oh, you'll be so blessed. So you know what? We will see you on Wednesday. It's good to see you again. And keep praising the Lord.